This is a part of the experience. These are the actual recordings that they listened to when they were teenagers, the exact recordings. And even 70 or 80 years later, when we hear it again, those memories are activated, and it's so powerful that it influences other memories. Alzheimer's, dementia, Parkinson's, PTSD.
And the Andrews sister, 1944, and there'll be a hot time in the town of Berlin.
Some of our participants are not ambulatory, and you know, some of them can't move very much because of their health condition, but you can see it in their eyes that something's being recognized.
I announce the song, which is usually announcing the song, who the performer is, and that's usually a band plus a singer or a group. I also announce the year that it was popular and anything else about the song or the singers that's important, and then I play it, the whole song. And while I'm playing it, I go around the room and take the hands of every person there for a minute and a half or 2 minutes, and I hand dance with them. Once in a while, they will get up and we'll hold on to each other and do a little bit of waltzing or dancing, but never even for a whole song. Lots of these people are very shaky on their feet and are in walkers or even wheelchairs, and so hand dancing is much more common than stand-up dancing.
Do you close your eyes, pretending?
They evaluate the data, and they help by training the testers, which I supply. Now, with USC's guidance, we're not only doing therapy groups, but we're doing control groups. So we have people who are in the therapy and people who aren't, to directly compare.
And is Zeke doing what comes naturally?